Do you use Dropbox for file storage? Did you know that you can integrate it with Jotform? Let me show you how. Hey Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and like I mentioned, if you use Dropbox to store data, you can absolutely integrate it with Jotform to send submissions and files to Dropbox. So as you can see, I'm currently in the desktop version of my workspace. And as of right now, I currently only have my forms chosen. And for this example, we're going to use my tech support form. So let's go ahead and edit this form. It's a very simple form, just name, email, phone number, description of the tech problem they're having, and the ability for them to upload a file. So I'm gonna head up to the top middle. We'll choose settings on the left-hand side. We'll do integrations, and let's do a quick search for Dropbox. Perfect. Now from here, if you've never logged in before, this is where you're going to integrate and authenticate your Dropbox account. Mine is already there, so I'm going to go ahead and authenticate. Now here is where we're going to tell it exactly what we want it to do. So the first one is it's going to create a folder for us right off the bat. We don't have to create a new folder in Dropbox whatsoever. I'm actually going to go up to the top, Dropbox. This is my Dropbox account. You can see it right here. I have no folder called tech support. So let's go ahead and head back. Next, it's asking, do we want to create a subfolder for each submission? Let's go ahead and turn that on, and we can give that folder a name. As of right now, it's the submission ID, but what we can do is we can pull from the form fields. So I'm going to go ahead and do name, and then I'm also going to do the description, which is going to be the tech problem that they're having. Now you can see we have two different PDF options or file options. The first one is going to be the submission PDF. So this one is going to send an overall recap of the form that was filled out. And then the uploaded files one, this is going to be any file that is uploaded on our form. All right, we are good to go. Let's go ahead and save. All right, we can see we have that right here. If we need to rename it, we can. If we want to see the action logs every single time this is ran, or if there was any issues, we can see that here. And if we want to disable or delete, we can do that here as well. So let's go ahead and open this file. I'm actually going to jump back over here, and I didn't even have to refresh. We can see that tech support file right here. And here is that file, open, ready to go. So I'm going to head back. Let's preview our form, and I'm going to do a quick fill form. And instead of the text box sample, I'm going to do problem with email. And I have a PDF on my desktop. I'm just going to click and drag it in. All right. And we can submit. All right, let's head back over. I'm going to do a quick refresh. And here is John Smith, and we see the name of the folder is name plus the description, which is problem with email. And down here we have the two files. We have the overall submission, and then we have the file that was uploaded. And it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to integrate Jotform with Dropbox, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button, and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.